So Chris, you and Siddharth are going to get together and you're going to go over those lessons under that tree that you planned. And you're going to come up with all of those women's issues you're going to understand. We've come to the end of our discussion. Secretary Clinton, if you could leave us with one last word. You talked about a backlash. How do you see this backlash against women's rights and what can be done about it?
I see it as a reaction that is, you know, driven by lots of different motives, some of them having to do with people feeling insecure, frightened, disappointed, discouraged, name whatever emotion you want, about their lives and the ongoing globalization of the economy, which is leaving many people out, and we haven't seen anything yet, because wait till robotics and AI, artificial intelligence, really take off. And so when people are insecure and anxious, they often defend against their own feelings by rejecting others. And that often happens with minorities, it happens with ethnicities, races, religions, and it also happens with respect to women. So any of you who've read my book about what happened know that I think that misogyny and sexism was part of that campaign. It was one of the contributing factors, and some of it was old-fashioned sexism and a refusal to accept the equality of women and certainly the equality of women's leadership, and some of it as an outgrowth of all this anxiety and insecurity that is playing on people and leading them in a hunt for scapegoats. So we've got to deal with that here at home, and I think that comes through the ballot box. This is an election year, 2018 in the United States, so there's a lot that can be done to say, wait a minute, we're not going backwards when it comes to race and religion and sex and gay rights and all the rest of it. We're going to keep forward moving because we want an inclusive, tolerant society. And that includes everybody, not just some of us, but all of us. So certainly voting remains the principal way that every individual can express an opinion, and anyone who chooses not to vote basically cedes that opinion to others who perhaps don't hold your values. And then speaking up and speaking out against the backlash or against the atrocities being committed against women and girls elsewhere is critically important as well. And we've talked about some of the ways of doing that. But remaining vigilant, remaining a very committed advocate on behalf of women and girls here at home and around the world, and helping others to understand why you feel that way and why it's important, why you took time out to come to this event for the Institute, all has positive incremental effects. So there's a lot of work to be done, but I end up being very confident and optimistic because we are not going back and women's voices are not shutting up.
Secretary Clinton, thank you. Wei Wei, Nadia, thank you. And thank you to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.